Eve and I am dressed as Santa. Hey there, would you like a gift?
Oh yes, I'd like a gift.
Then get in the bag.
No.
Please get in the bag.
No, I don't want to.
Just what in fucking tarnation you think you were doing that you haven't seen me passing through, young lady? Mama, welcome back.
Hi, Yor. Where are the groceries?
Oh, that. Sorry, guys. A young teenager crashed with me and made me drop all the stuff I bought for tonight's Christmas dinner.
No need for worries. If you want, I can go buy them myself.
Really? Would you do that for me? Thank you so much, Lloyd, my darling. Who could it be?
Don't worry, I'll check it myself. Yes? President Vernon and Vice President Erica? What are the biggest authorities of the U.S. government doing here in London?
First of all, Merry Christmas, Agent Twilight. Second, we have a huge favor to ask you and your wife.
Sure, please come in and tell us everything you want us to do.
Please, excuse us. Oh my. An elegant haps you and Thorn Princess speak to stay and live a normal life that differs from your jobs, Agent Twilight.
Thanks. Buying this house was just a small part in our plan to enroll Anya to Eden Academy. And thankfully, all this tension has worth it in the end.
Anya?
I'm Anya. I've always been Papa's daughter.
What a cute creature you adopted as your daughter. Seeing you reminds me a lot of the nice relationship I have with my two little kids and my husband. Thanks a lot, Ms. Bartholomew. I'm so glad seeing us reminds you a lot to your healthy family relationship.
I apologize for changing the subject, but I have to tell you why we've come here.
Oh right, I forgot about that. Please proceed, Mr. Vernon.
Well, you see, Agent Twilight. A really sus aura started to manifest around Washington, D.C., and it's a power that equals to the one of the Gear Maker. So, along with Erica, Giovanna and Goldlewis, whom latter is Santa Claus, we'll investigate the source of that energy, and since other heroes are busy spending time with their loved ones, I wanted to assignate this mission to you since the three of you have enough requirements to stay together while accomplishing this task.
And since Goldlewis is finding someone to deliver the presents around the globe in his absence, we would also appreciate if you take care of his wife, reindeers and workshop, if it's not too much trouble.
Do not worry. The Forgers will be there to save Christmas. After all, it is a dream I wanted to accomplish since I was a kid.
One day, I will save Christmas.
Wait, really? I always wanted to save Christmas alongside a spy.
One day, I will save Christmas alongside a spy.
So anyway, just leave it to us. We'll protect Santa's important ones and his work during what remains of Christmas.
We wish you the best luck, Agents Twilight and Thorn Princess.
We'll head to the North Pole. We'll head to the North Pole. We'll head to the North Pole. We'll head to the North Pole.
So, this is what that lady wants me to tell you. The rest of life will be covering any other area of the North Pole as you take care of Santa's house and workshop. I would love to have helped you, but everyone else agreed that you can take care of your family and everything tasked to you by yourself.
By the way, Nightfall. You guys did not mention who or what are we going to deal with in the North Pole to protect every area related to Santa Dickinson.
Have you ever heard of Krampus? Every year he attempts on kidnapping little kids and elves to eat them. And since Santa forgot to put his annual protection due to time constraints, we'll do the job for him repelling that bastard.
In that case, we have to make sure Anya is safe at any cost. This is the place. Operation Protect Christmas begins now.
Oh, you must be the people my husband told me it would come visit me this Christmas. Please, come in.
Thanks. Please excuse us.
Holy people, that lady is huge.
During the last hours I couldn't stop thinking about the arrival of that monster, but I'm glad you decided to come all the way to the North Pole to protect us. Please. It is more than a pleasure to be the bodyguards of the wife of the man who brought many smiles to the people of the world in the last decades. Oh, please stop. You're making me very happy from marrying a man like my Goldlewis. Wanna know the story of how did we become what we are now?
Sure. I mean, if every hero has a genesis, why not Santa too?
Well then, this is the origin of Santa Claus. Goldlewis Dickinson, after retiring from the battlefield at the end of World War II, started working to promote Coca-Cola soft drinks on every December. One day, on the way to his work, he found a little kid in misery, and gave him clothes and money to buy some food for him and his family. This honorable act gave him recognition as the kindest man who stepped on earth and even made me fall in love with him. Once we got married, the God of Light appeared and rewarded these nice actions by making us immortal and have the task to bring happiness to everyone every 24th and 25th of December. And what about the kid from early on the story? The kid's name was Chris Maxwell, and based on that name, that's how the name Christmas was born and was declared the day of pure happiness and joy for the good and bad people. And to make sure the kindness stays, Goldlewis concentrated and trained to relinquish the evil within, resulting on a fission that gave birth to his evil counterpart, Krampus.
So that famous Krampus is Santa's evil counterpart trying to annihilate his good side, right? Wait, where's Anya?
Well, but I thought you were keeping an eye on her, Lloyd.
That young lady is exposing herself to be caught up by Krampus himself. We have to find her as soon as possible.
And now, the moment to pick which toys would be the best companions for Mr. Chimera.
A big deal. We cannot handle it.
While a new prize to escape from Krampus, let's see how Lowe's group is do right now.
Well, we're off.
Yes, we're off.
We're off to save Christmas.
Off to save Christmas.
And we're cold.
Super cold.
Yes, we forgot our jackets. Cause we didn't bring our jackets, so we'll freeze, and we'll...
Cut that out, ladies. Alright, Ms. Claus. Since you live here for decades by now, tell us where are we now? Because we're lost.
And we're lost! Oh, so lost! And we can't feel our fingers! No, we can't feel our...
I said cut that out. Just great. If it weren't because the communication with Wise lost its signal, I wouldn't be in the middle of nowhere with a couple of dorksicles.
Oh dear God. Anya.
Papa, Mama, they're there behind that gear.
They're there. Mama has arrived to your rescue. Was the last one. guess it was a terrible idea that you let me have all the cookies and milk of the world for myself.
Thank goodness I've arrived on time. For what I'm seeing, you have succeeded on your task. Now, why don't you go inside as I check the sleigh for myself?
Hey, I might have got bloated, but at least I can bring more love and hugs now.
And that's why I never lose weight. Huh. Well, well. Looks like good old Krampus has been defeated even without myself activating the North Pole's protection. Since I have bigger things to worry about now, I'm afraid your free trial of life has expired, El Pam.
Is him a foe, Santa? Do you want us to give you a hand on this?
Thank you, Aria and Celica, but I can handle this by myself. Now, prepare to die, Krampus.
Thanks for taking the time to stay the day taking care of the North Pole while Goldlewis was on the United States. The pleasure is ours.
I'm gonna miss you too so much.
Do not worry, Anya. Since your parents are a spy and an assassin, I can fully guarantee that we'll be seeing each other more often during our job, since evil seems to be growing stronger with every bad guy we stop and or kill.
Ah, yes. Anya will see Santa more days of the year.
By the way, Goldlewis, what were you investigating at the White House?
Well, Mr. Forger, I'm afraid the force we were investigating is something out of our members. Those bad guys always find a way to disturb our peace, isn't it?
Out of our members? Something is telling me right now that a bigger challenge is approaching our organizations, and with many tricks under their sleeves. Once the Christmas holidays are over, I will talk not only with my partners but with Shinriso Arisu or Hiroshima, spread the news to the other heroes, hopefully at the speed of light.
With all the information she gave to us, I am more than convinced this memiverse will be the perfect cradle for us to unleash despair. After all, the most important thing to us are drama and fetishism.
Santa, tell me.